Welcome to this instructional video on using the OBIS IUD remover. The IUD remover has been designed to safely and effectively retrieve a trapped IUD by taking the physician's comfort level into consideration. So, if you can sound the uterus using a uterine sound, you can also use the OBIS IUD remover. The design of the IUD remover also takes into consideration the patient's comfort and safety. Step 1. Confirm IUD placement with ultrasound. Before attempting IUD removal, it's essential that the patient has had a pelvic ultrasound to confirm that the device is still positioned within the uterine cavity. The ultrasound usually shows that the IUD is appropriately positioned, but sometimes it is malpositioned. It also tells you if the patient's uterus is antiverted or retroverted. Step 2, flange adjustment. The IUD remover features an adjustable flange designed to accommodate the patient's uterocervical length. To adjust the flange, use the patient's recorded uterocervical length from previous measurements as a reference. If no prior measurement is available, you can use the uterine length from the pelvic ultrasound. Subtract 2 centimeters from the previous uterocervical length or uterine length shown in the ultrasound. The flange's maximum adjustable length is 8 centimeters. A safety feature that helps prevent excessive advancement of the device into the uterine cavity. It's important to note that, unlike the flange of an IUD inserter, which is designed to reach the external boss of the cervix, the flange of the IUD remover need not be advanced to the external boss. Step 3, locating the IUD string. The IUD's threads are typically found in the cervical canal or lower uterine cavity along the midline. Therefore, it's a good practice to begin your search in the upper part of the cervical canal. Advance the IUD remover into the cervical canal. Open and close the jaws of the IUD remover to search for the string of the IUD. Pull back gently to check if the device has been successfully grasped. Step 4. Locating the lower or mid-stem of the IUD. If you're unable to grasp the IUD as described in Step 3, advance the IUD remover into the uterine cavity and repeat the search. A tenaculum might need to be applied to the cervix to straighten the uterocervical angle, which would facilitate advancing the IUD remover into the uterine cavity. Open and close the jaws and gently pull back to see if you've successfully grasped the device. Step 5. Further advancement if needed. If you still can't locate the IUD after following the instructions in Step 4, you can advance the IUD remover a little further into the uterine cavity, but remember to keep the flange at a safe distance from the external eus of the cervix. Throughout the procedure, always ensure that you pay careful attention to the patient's comfort and safety. Some patients might need to have a gentle cervical dilatation under local anesthetic cover to successfully retrieve the device.